Hi, my name is Nuno Bacharel, and for this edition of the Meet the Experts, we'll be talking with a respect figure in the field of fire science. We'll be talking with Dr. Guillermo Rein, Professor of Fire Science at the Department of Mechanical Engineering of Imperial College in London. Today, Guillermo will be telling us more about his work in fire science and his views on the role and the future of fire safety. Let's talk with Guillermo. Let's talk bromine. Hello, Guillermo. Thank you so much for joining us. I'd like to start by asking you, why did you decide to pursue a career in fire science?
Hello, Nuno. Thank you for this opportunity. So I am a mechanical engineer in all my degrees. When I was studying my PhD at the University of California at Berkeley, I was studying fires in spacecraft. But when I graduated, I realized that I wanted to have a career here on Earth. And then is when I discovered that there are a lot of undone issues regarding fire safety in buildings and in the forest.
You just mentioned fire safety. And why is fire safety an important public health issue, in your view?
So we humans discover fire. Fire is a natural phenomenon. We discovered it about 1.5 million years ago. Fire has given us an incredible amount of good things. It is the greatest discovery of humanity. It gave us evolution, heating, cooking, metallurgy, science, etc. But it also came with a dark side. The fact that we humans are surrounded by flammable environments in our homes or even outside our homes, and the fact that fire accidentally or when it's too large kills lives, destroys property, and it damages ecosystems.
In our homes, we often hear about product safety recalls due to the risk of fire from product failures. Do you think that consumers generally recognize everyday fire risk in the products they buy?
That's quite interesting. It's almost social science. In developed communities, in developed countries, fire safety has been so safe for the last several decades that people have a tendency to forget that fire is a hazard daily in their houses. That, I have to say, is probably a success story of fire safety engineering, fire safety in general, and consumer products. But that also means that when the product makes it to market and it doesn't meet the safety requirements, then suddenly customers, people, are surprised to have fires, to have smoke, to have to evacuate, and to actually lose their properties and sometimes even lives. And they are surprised about this. Fire safety engineers are not surprised about this because we are fighting fires every day.
Yeah. We have seen in the last 20 years a dramatic rise in the number and variety of electrical and electronic equipment in houses, offices, and public buildings. Has fire safety improved during the same periods? And do you think we live and work in a more fire safety environments?
That is fascinating because it is a fact that since polymers were invented, we humans have been increasing the flammability or the fuel content of our homes and our houses and our offices. My office today is way more flammable in terms of the fuel that it contains than it was 50 years ago with another academic. Yet, my office is safer than the offices in the past. So what is it that we are doing that although we are bringing more materials that could ignite, that they're actually not igniting? And the answer to this is that we are understanding how to control the flammability of the products that are brought into market.
Can you please explain to us how do fire generally start in electronic devices?
So the beginning of a fire, the process of ignition, is when a combustible material or a flammable material meets an ignition source. This is a little bit more complex than this because it has to be a material that is very flammable in contact with an ignition source that is very powerful. So we can still have small ignition sources and we can still have materials that are a little bit flammable, and that's safe. The problem is when the ignition source is too strong or the material that we have in the home is too flammable. So the key is to control flammability and ignition sources and separate them in a way that then, like this office, is a safe place.
And how do manufacturers protect products from failures and possible fires? And which product materials are combustible? And how can product engineers reduce their propensity to burn?
Engineers and manufacturers, they make sure that the product doesn't have a failure. If it's an electrical system, it's very important it doesn't fail, it doesn't overheat, it doesn't arc, it doesn't have a short circuit. But also, that's not enough, also that the plastic, the polymer, the casing, the material of the element is protected and it doesn't have high flammability, so decrease its flammability. There are many ways of how to decrease the flammability of a component. There are different ways to do this. One of the most popular currently as we speak is to bring in flame retardants, which is an element that is added to the polymer in particular, and it makes the polymer to have less flammability. You immediately control the flammability, and the more you put of this flame retardant, the more you actually decrease the flammability.
There are a lot of different flame retardants, including brominated flame retardants. Can you tell us about unique benefits of brominated flame retardants and explain why these chemicals are widely used?
So my expertise is on heat transfer and on the solid, so I'm not an expert on the chemistry of flame retardants, but what I see is the benefit of the flame retardants, like for example bromide, is that they actually hinder the formation of a flame. It's very difficult when in the presence of bromide, the flame doesn't burn well, literally. So still heat happens, still the ignition source is there, but bromide and other chemicals, they really stop the flame from forming, which is a very effective way of preventing the fire from growing or continuing burning.
Okay, we have talked about the increasing number of plastics, of electronics in our houses and offices. Where do you see a need for new research and scientific discovery in the area of fire safety?
We still need more understanding and more control of flammability. We are far from having full control. We need more solutions to the fact that polymers are everywhere in our houses, but all of them have a level of flammability. We need to control that. We need new technologies, and we need to keep lowering that.
Okay, fantastic. Guillermo, it has been very insightful to talk with you, and I would like to thank you so much to give us your views on fire safety. And I would like to ask those that watch this video to follow us on our Twitter and LinkedIn account, and of course to subscribe to the next editions of the Let's Talk Bromine newsletter. Thank you.